So actor Dean Cain has a problem with the new Superman coming out as bisexual, but it's not what you think.
You'd read that?
No.
Okay.
DC Comics recently announced that the son of Superman and Lois Lane, John Kent, is bisexual after he falls for a male reporter. But Dean, who played Superman in the late 90s TV show Lois and Clark, has an issue with it. Listen to what he had to say.
I say they're bandwagoning. You know, a Robin of Batman, a Robin, as you mentioned, just came out as bi or gay recently, and honestly, who's really shocked about that one? I had some thoughts about that a long time ago. But the new Captain America is gay. My daughter in Supergirl, where I played the father, she was gay. So I don't think it's bold or brave or some crazy new direction. If they had done this 20 years ago, perhaps that would have been bold and brave.
So Dean added that it would have been bolder for Superman to fight real injustices like the Taliban's treatment of women and the discrimination against gay people around the world. Erica, what do you make about his points?
I was fully prepared to disagree with Dean Cain, but I was like, well, he's right. I mean, when we talk about representation, representation is not enough. Representation is the first step that has to have action behind it. He's right when he said if it were 20 years ago and they were the first to do it, then it might have been considered groundbreaking. But so many other franchises and situations have already had representation of LGBTQIA. What would be really putting action behind it is, yes, if there is a message that has to do with it. It's not enough, and I think that it just, in my opinion, it's not enough for people just to be there. There has to be, like, intention behind that. That's how I feel about it.
And me and Erica were talking about this earlier. I thought representation was fighting against, you know, anti-stereotypes, whatever. I thought that was a good thing, right?
It is a good thing.
And I thought the first step is a good thing, because how are we supposed to have full representation if we don't take that first step? So me and Erica saw that a little differently when we
I don't think it. We see it differently. I'm just extending it. You're right. I'm just extending it out to say, when there is a lack of representation and you put someone there to represent a demographic, then it's kind of, without action behind it, it's kind of indicating that they didn't deserve to be there in the first place.
But we haven't seen the script yet. I agree with the both of you, but what if the script and everything that they're planning is going to include that?
Well, no, I admit I do not know the script. I don't know where he's going, but I'm saying Dean Cain, what he said was not controversial. I believe what he said was pretty spot on, because we have to stop thinking that just because someone's put in, they're put in order to represent. These are people who have lost opportunities because of who they are or what they look like. And the idea that they weren't ever qualified is just false.
Good conversation.